Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elektor. Several years ago, a colleague asked me to design a wearable microcontroller board with an ESP8266-based Wi-Fi module on it. He would do the firmware side of the project, as he had great plans for such a device. When I had the prototype ready, he gave the board a try and then left the company. So the project was abandoned. A few months back, when I was searching for an ESP8266 module in my drawers and boxes with parts that might come in handy someday, I stumbled upon my wearable prototype. And I immediately knew that I now had all the tools to quickly create some software for this board, namely ESPHome. The board is basically a round NodeMCU with the Silabs CP2101 USB-to-serial bridge replaced by a cheaper FT231XS from FTDI. Also, the board has a port for an addressable WS2812 type LED string, also known as NeoPixels. The GPIO ports and power supply are brought out to special pads with large holes placed in a circle at the edge of the round board. These pads are intended for use with conductive thread, but you can, of course, also solder wires to them or use crocodile clips. Power for the circuit is supplied by either the micro USB port or by connecting an external 5V power supply. This is useful when using long LED strings, as they demand more power than a normal USB port can provide. A high-capacity USB power bank is also an option. For my experiments, I connected a ring-shaped string of 12 WS2812 LEDs. Of course, you can write the software for this board from scratch, but adopting an open-source project like ESPHome saves you a huge amount of work. ESPHome uses a modular approach where ready-made code blocks are combined to form an application. The blocks required by the application are listed in a configuration file, the so-called YAML file. YAML, yet another markup language, is the name of the text formatting rules used inside the file. Each block is configured individually to specify, for instance, which GPIO pins it should use or which communication protocol and things like that. ESPHome turns this configuration file into C++ code, compiles it and uses it to program the module. Once you have understood how to compose a YAML configuration file, you're in business. The YAML configuration file starts with the obligatory ESPHome section to specify a name for the device, the MCU type used, ESP8266 in this case, and the board type, which is a NodeMCU. Next comes the Wi-Fi section to specify the network to connect to and the rescue options in case of network problems. Note that the order of these sections has no importance. Specifying the logger option activates the status output on the serial port. The API option enables easy integration with Home Assistant, and OTA is for over-the-air device programming, which is very practical as it removes the requirement of having a physical connection to the device. Next comes the meat of the application. I define the LED string as a light. The string is handled by the NeoPixel bus platform. It has a few options that must be specified, like the number of LEDs in the string and the port that it is connected to. In this case, the port is GPIO2, which allows the use of the ESP8266 UART1 method. Now the LED string is driven by a real efficient hardware peripheral instead of by a time-consuming bit-banging emulation in software. Lights can have effects, and ESPHome has a few built-in that you can use. You can, of course, also program your own light effects. I specified most of the built-in effects for the LED ring. Effects can have parameters, but without them, default values will be used. The unused GPIO ports are declared as switches, so you can toggle them on and off from within the Home Assistant. In home automation, a switch is a device like a relay that is controlled by the system. A switch or a push button that is controlled by the user is a binary sensor. GPIO0 has a push button connected to it, and therefore it is specified as a binary sensor. Finally, the board has an analog input on pin A0 with a voltage divider in front of it. The multiplication factor of 3.2 converts the input signal back to volts. The maximum input voltage is 3.3 volts. Adding the LED ring to Home Assistant is easy. In the overview, enter Edit Dashboard mode. Then click the Add Cart button. Then look for the type of device you want to add. We want the light, so we click the light card. Now you must choose the entity from the drop-down list. An entity is a connected object like a switch or a light that the Home Assistant can use. Look through the list and pick the LED ring. All other things are optional, but giving the card a name you can remember is practical. Now you have a card with which you can control the LED ring. By clicking the card, you can switch the ring on and off, and you can set the brightness. When the brightness is not zero, you can also set the color and the effect. Click in the color wheel to pick a color. By clicking the palette icon, you can switch between discrete steps and smooth. To select an effect, open the effect drop-down list. Here are all the effects that are defined in the ESPHome YAML file. My favorite effect is Twinkle Random. Close the card when done. Both ESPHome and Home Assistant feature automation. As an example, you could add a sensor to the board to change the color or effect of the LED ring depending on what the sensor sees. Or Home Assistant can light it when someone rings a doorbell. It can also just be a decorative electronic pin or brooch. Just let your imagination go wild. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.